It all comes down to origins. So understanding how star clusters form in the Milky Way pretty much tells us how most stars form in the Milky Way. One very important survey that was done some time ago about the star-forming clouds in the Milky Way, sort of old and needed updating. The old-fashioned way to do it was to use a small telescope to map big pixels so that we could cover the area. But instead, what we realized was if we used a big telescope to map small pixels, sure, it would take longer, but because it's a big telescope, it's far more sensitive. And so it was kind of an aha. The particular telescope we chose happened to have a receiver which could detect many different chemicals inside these clouds that form stars at the same time. And so the image shows in different colors three different chemicals that we can use to identify basically the temperature and the total mass in these clouds that allows us to do the physics just by looking at the image. And so that will give us a much better, a much deeper insight for the distribution of all this material in the Milky Way and where star formation and solar system formation of this in clusters happens. In the astronomy department here in Florida, what's important is that we try to push the boundaries of our understanding of the universe that we're in as many directions as we can, and as well engage our own students and community and the public in what we're doing and why we think it's exciting and interesting.